Hi guys, welcome to EdiTap, and today we will be discussing important topics from the point of view of general awareness section from 17th and 18th of October's newspapers. And this video will be highly useful for RBI grade B, NABARD grade A, and SEBI grade A, and RBI assistant and NABARD assistant exams. So let's start. See, the first news pertains to Swasth Bharat Yatra. Okay, it's not Swachh Bharat, it's Swasth Bharat. Yani ke Healthy Bharat Yatra. And it's a campaign that was launched by the Union Government on 16th of October 2018. And every year on 16th of October, we celebrate World Food Day. So these two are very important facts for you. And this campaign has been launched to sensitize people about eating safe and healthy food. And in it, an All India Cycle Rally was organized to create consumer awareness about eating safe and nutritious food. And for combating food adulteration. Food adulteration, it means when certain chemicals or certain unwanted things are added in the food items, and that is done to dupe people, because those unwanted things that have been added, they are actually costing the shopkeepers lesser than what the original food item costs. For example, in pepper, sometimes papaya seeds are mixed. And even in milk, we know that how artificial milk is being produced. So this is referred to as food adulteration. And this campaign has been launched by the Union Government in association with states and led by FSSAI. FSSAI stands for Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. Moving on, the second news pertains to Central Warehouse of Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana. And this has been set up at Bilaspur in Gurugram. Actually, there are 2-3 Bilaspurs in India. One we have seen, it's in Gurugram, another is in Himachal Pradesh, and another is in Chhattisgarh. And this has been set up by the Bureau of Pharma PSUs of India. That is BPPI. Okay, and what will be the purpose of this? The purpose is to facilitate distribution of Jan Aushadhi medicines to all the Pradhan Mantri BJP Kendra functional centers across the country. And what is PM BJP? It's actually a campaign launched by the Department of Pharmaceuticals of the Government of India. Very important for you. And it provides generic medicines. That is, generic medicines are those medicines which are unbranded but are but cost very, very less than those branded medicines. And in generic medicines, the efficacy and efficiency is same as that of branded medicines. And these are also known as Jan Aushadhis. So these Jan Aushadhi, they are supplied to the masses at affordable prices through Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Kendras that have been set up under this campaign. That is Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana. And to facilitate seamless distribution of generic medicines to all these Kendras that are throughout India, this central warehouse has been set up at Bilaspur in Gurugram. Gurugram is the new name of Gurgaon, and it's in Haryana. Moving on, the Kulgod village of Karnataka, it has ranked number 1 in the Antyodaya scheme of the center. Okay, and this falls in Belagavi district of Karnataka. And its total score has been 94 out of 100. And let us know something about this village. Actually, this village lies on the banks of Ghat Prabha River. And this village is a clean village and is a green village. And it is scored on the following parameters. There were 47 parameters, and it scored high on especially on these infrastructure parameter and financial inclusion parameter and women's empowerment and health and education parameters. And this village alone has two big banks and four schools. And the economy here is aided by agriculture, and almost 90% of this its area, it's irrigated by Ghat Prabha right bank canal and by Rameshwar lift irrigation project. And there is also BSNL service center here and an electricity supply customer care center also. And the population is around 7,000 people, and it has around 5,200 people, those are registered as voters. Moving on, Anna Burns, she has become the first Northern Irish author to win the Man Booker Prize. Man Booker Prize is given in the field of literature, and she has been given this £50,000 award for her novel Milkman. For her novel Milkman, and it's a novel that tells the story of an unnamed 18-year-old girl, and she's known as Middle Sister, who is being sexually harassed by a powerful man who is much older and is a paramilitary person, and he's called as the Milkman. And this is Anna Burns' third novel, and according to the chair of judges, Mr. Who is philosopher Kwame Anthony Appiah, it is this novel is incredibly original. Moving on, MyGov has made an app hashtag Self for Society, and it has been launched by the government to coordinate the volunteer work that is undertaken by professionals. See, professionals sometimes take many initiatives such as corporate social responsibility CSR and other initiatives at their own individual levels also, and it has been found that if employees give, it leads to satisfaction and lesser of attrition amongst employees. So to create synergies between all these organizations, this app has been launched, and this app will have incentives also, and there will be games and inter-company competitions, and there will also be social networking through this app. And through this app, schemes such as Swachh Bharat program and all, they are expected to have an increased volunteer time. There's a very important news. The city of Allahabad, where the confluence of Ganga, Yamuna and also river Saraswati is said to be there, it has been renamed as Prayagraj. And the UP government has taken this decision since the city of Allahabad was originally known as Prayag in ancient times. In ancient India, the city of Allahabad was known as Prayag. In medieval India, Mughal Emperor Akbar, named it as Allahabad. Okay, he named it as Allahabad, but where this Triveni Sangam, that is Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati, are said to meet, that place was known as Sangam, while the area around it where a fort was built by Akbar, that was known as Allahabad, which meant the abode of the god, that is home of the god. And it was done because it was inspired by Deen-e-Ilahi. Deen-e-Ilahi was the religion founded by Akbar, in which he took important and useful points and positive points, what he thought to be useful, positive and good points from every religion, and this he created a beautiful amalgamation. But in the later years, Akbar's grandson Shah Jahan, he renamed the entire city as Allahabad. And however, where the Kumbh Mela is held, that is Triveni place, that area is known as Sangam, and it even then it continued to be called as Prayag. And now the whole city has been renamed as Prayagraj. Okay, Prayagraj. See, the sixth edition of IISF, that is India International Silk Fair, it is being held in New Delhi, and it is being organized by ISEPC. ISEPC stands for Indian Silk Export Promotion Council, and it is envisaged as a platform for exporters to display their products and to overseas buyers to place their orders and source their merchandise. And you see, India is the second largest producer of silk in the world, and India's silk industry is agricultural based primarily and labor intensive, so it provides employment to many people. And around 8 million artisans and weavers in rural areas, they are gainfully employed in this industry. And in India, about 97% of the raw mulberry silk, it is produced in the five Indian states. Which are those five Indian states? First is Karnataka, second is Andhra Pradesh, then Tamil Nadu, then West Bengal, and the last one, Jammu and Kashmir. And this Mysore and North Bangalore, they contribute to the majority of the silk production. And at North Bangalore, US dollar 20 million worth silk city is coming up. Moving on to the questions, you have to tell me the name of the first Northern Irish author to win Man Booker Prize. Is it Anne Burns or Anne Hathaway or Anna Burns or Anna Karenina or none of the above? The correct answer is Anna Burns for her novel The Milkman. Moving on, which is the site of the upcoming US dollar 20 million silk city in India? Is it North Bangalore or Coimbatore or Belagavi or Chennai? The correct answer is North Bangalore. Moving on, Kulgod village lies on the banks of which river? Is it Malprabha or Ghatprabha or Kaveri or Yamuna or none of these? Confusing question, a bit confusing. The correct answer is Ghatprabha. You may remember it like this, Ghatprabha ke ghat par. This Kulgod village lies, Kulgod village is in Karnataka and falls in Belagavi district. And it has been ranked as the best and the most developed Indian village under the central government's Antyodaya scheme. Moving on, where has been the central warehouse for Pradhan Mantri Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana set up? Is it Gurugram or Noida or Rohtak or Karnal or none of the above? The correct answer is Gurugram, Bilaspur in Gurugram. Gurugram is the new name of Gurgaon. When is the World Food Day celebrated? Is it 16th of October or 17th of October or 18th of October or 12th October or 26th October? Very factual question. Think about it. The correct answer is 16th of October. World Food Day is celebrated, and on 16th of October of 2018, the Union Government of India has launched Swasth Bharat National Campaign, not Swachh, Swasth Bharat Campaign. It's an All India cycling rally to make people aware of the need to eat healthy food, and for consumers you can say awakening regarding food adulteration. And if you liked our video, please subscribe to our channel and please like and share the video, And if you would like to know about more of our courses, you may visit our website, that is www.edutap.co.in. And thank you and happy learning.